Hi everyone, and welcome back to GameMaker Cast. It's Mickey, and in this video, we're going to get started on the Warp Space Shooter. So download the starter project found in the description below, and let's get right into it. If we run the demo project that we downloaded, there's already a bunch of things done for us. You can see we have the little menu here, we have a play game, quick game, both those buttons work, and we have a nice transition. There's just some things that didn't really feel like we needed to cover in this tutorial, and so I will give you the code and you can look at it as you please. But what we want to get working on in this lesson is going to be the actual spawner. So let's take a look of our room, and let's go to the main room here. You can see up here in the instances, we already have a room initialization right here. If we go to that object and we go to the create event, you'll see that right now we are actually spawning the enemy in that spawner, so we don't have to do anything. However, what we do need to do is we need to actually code our spawner itself. So this spawner is going to be using some data structures and arrays, but everything is going to come together really nicely, so just bear with me. The first thing I want to do is I need a timer to count down when to spawn the waves, and I need a variable to keep track of our current wave that we are on. So I'll use these two variables here. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to create a new variable called waves, and this is going to be an array. Within this array, we are going to be using data structures, so we'll use the curly braces, and inside here we can have a bunch of named values or keys. For instance, for this wave, this is going to be wave number one. We want to make sure that we have a timer, so we'll set the timer, and we want a room speed times 5 to be 5 seconds. So in 5 seconds, wave one is going to actually happen. Within this wave, we're going to have a bunch of enemies. And again, we're going to use a data structure here. Now within the enemies, we are going to provide our wave spawner with a bunch of different elements that will help us initialize these enemies. For example, let's use the number of enemies that we want this wave to have. So I'm going to want this wave to have 6 enemies. What object do I want to spawn in? Well, I'm going to spawn in the object asteroid. Now, where do I want this object to spawn in? So the X position, let's start it at the room underscore width. So that's going to be all the way on the right. And we'll say plus 64, so it actually spawns off the screen. Again, let's do the same with the Y position. But in this time, we want to say the room height, divide it in 2, so it gets the middle of the room. Now, the next thing I want to do with this spawner is give it some intelligence, so it knows I'm not going to spawn all the objects at once, but I can move the objects left or right, up and down. So in this particular case, I will use a X underscore padding, and I want to set this to 38. This is a positive number, so that means that our spawner is going to move over to the right 38 pixels and spawn the next asteroid, and then move 38 pixels again and spawn it again. We'll do the same for the Y padding, but in this case we will use 0. Now this is all good, but there's one thing that we need to do to get it working. And if we switch over to the step event, what we need to do is we need to make sure whatever current wave we're on does not extend beyond that array. So we can do this with an if statement. We can say if our current wave is bigger than however many elements in our array that we have, then we know that we are at the end of that array. And really there's no reason to keep this one in memory, so let's just do an instance destroy, and then we will say return, which won't run any more code in the step event. If we come down here, we know that we are within that range. Let's increase our timer by 1. And once our timer is increased, we can check the current wave that we're on. For example, we could say if our timer is bigger or equal to waves, and then we want to pass in our current underscore wave. So that's the wave that we're on dot timer. And remember that this is referring to our array. This is referring to the element in the array, which is normally going to be 0 to start off. And then this is the actual variable of our data structure. So this is timer right here. So if this timer is bigger or equal to whatever timer we set that to, then we know that we are going to have to come in here and show the enemies on the screen. So before we actually instantiate the objects, let's start out with some of the positions. We need a position X and Y, which is going to keep track of where we are in our spawner. Now I'm going to use a for statement here. I'm going to say for a enemy underscore index, which is going to be our counter, set it to 0, and if the enemy index is less than the waves of our current wave, so whatever current wave we're on, dot enemies dot underscore count. And again, this was referring to right here, we're inside enemies and count, so we're going to count to 6. Then what we want to do is we want to increase the enemy underscore index by one. So this is just going to loop through all of those enemies, starting from zero and going to six. Now what we need to do is we need to start by grabbing the X and Y position. So we'll start with the X position, and this is going to just equal whatever our array is with the current wave. And then we'll say we also need to go within enemies here, and then we'll grab the X position. We'll do the same thing with Y. We'll just make sure we change them all to Y here. And then the final thing we need to do is add in the padding. So you remember in the create event, we said the padding for this one is going to be 38 pixels. So that means that if we look at our room here, the room main, we're going to spawn over here in the middle, and then we're going to move 38 pixels, spawn another one, 38 pixels, 38 pixels, and continue on until we have six asteroids. So to do this, this is actually pretty easy. All we need to do is take our position X, and we'll add the enemy underscore index times whatever the wave is, the current wave, the enemies, and then we need to reference that X underscore padding. And we'll do the same thing, but we'll change it for the Y. So we'll change it to position Y and Y padding, and this will handle everything for us. So the first time it's going to come in, it will be 0 times 38, which is 0, then 1 times 38, which is 1. So we're just adding on that into the position. The final thing we need to do is instantiate that specific variable. So we will use an instance underscore create underscore depth, and we want it to be at the position of X, the position of Y, the current depth is fine, and then the object that we want to spawn in, again, we'll just copy everything we have here, and we need to refer to the underscore object variable. So that is referring to this guy right here on line 11. Now that we've spawned in six enemies, there is only really one thing we need to do. We need to reset the timer to zero and tell the current underscore wave variable to be plus equal one to move on to the next wave. So now with this complete, if I run my game and I hit play, we should have six asteroids coming from the far right once we are 5 seconds into our game. So let's make sure that they appear. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So perfect, they are indeed working. So what we could do is we could go to the create event, and you can see how easy this is. I can just take this, I could copy and paste it. Let's say wave number two, I want to have happen 2 seconds after wave number one. Instead of going to the middle, I'll say room height minus 64 to move up a little bit. I'll set my padding to zero, and because I want things to move up, I'm going to use a negative number of minus 38. Now when I run my game, we're going to go to wave one, which is going to be our asteroids going across the screen. And then wave two, we're going to start at the bottom and we're going to spawn them upwards. So we'll have our asteroids here, and then next will be those asteroids, and then our wave spawner is done. So that makes it really easy to add any objects that you want and also control the actual spawning of those particular objects. I'll end the lesson here, and I'll let you add in the waves that you want to add in and the different enemies, but thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Again, thank you for watching this video. If you're looking for the full source code to this and many other tutorials, check out my Patreon site found in the description below. Talking about Patreon, a special shout out to these supporters in no particular order. Mary, Thysite, Timothy, Victor, Robert, Susie, Paul, GameMaker Community, Ashby, and David. Again, thank you all for the support. If you like what you see and you want more, please click that subscribe button, and don't forget to hit that notification bell. I'll see you in the next video.